You can now teach or fine-tune your Microsoft 365 Copilot experience by creating your own task-specific fine-tune models that channel your expertise and experience to carry out specialized jobs and tasks accurately and on your behalf. In fact, from Copilot Studio, anyone can use this zero-code approach to teaching Copilot's underlying model the skills from your organization to produce more usable, high-quality responses that can be as detailed as they need to be, even hundreds of pages long to get the job done. And the model remains exclusive to your organization and only the people and departments you specify. If you compare this to the traditional way of doing this until now, this level of customization would require data science, machine learning, and coding skills. So this process is a lot simpler. And unlike existing approaches where, as a data scientist, you may be copying data into locations that may not be aware of your protections and access controls, this is enterprise grade by design. You just focus on the outcome that you want to achieve. And because your data stays in place, your existing data access and protection policies are respected by default. Let me show you the power of this in action by comparing the results of an agent that's calling a fine-tuned task-specific model of Copilot versus one that's just calling the original underlying Copilot model. So both agents are configured to author loan agreement documents. On the left is our agent using the task-specific model. On the right is our SharePoint-based agent using a general model. Now, both agents are focused on the same exact underlying knowledge. It's all in a SharePoint location, as you can see here with this precedent file set. And both user prompts are identical with example reference files and the client term sheets containing new information. In fact, this is a precedent file that I'll use. It's a long and detailed document with 14 pages and more than 5,000 words. The term sheet is quite a bit shorter, as you can see here, but it's still long and detailed with information about the loan amounts, all the details, and if I scroll all the way down to the bottom, you'll see signatory information for both parties. So let's go back to our side-by-side view and run them. So I'll start with the general model agent on the right, and it starts to generate its response. And I'll let this one respond for a moment until it completes. There we go. And now I'll move over to the agent on the left. It immediately informs me that I'll receive an email once it's finished. Now this is going to be a longer form document, so we'll fast forward in time to see each completed response. So starting with the general model, I've copied it into a Word document, and the output is solid. You'll see that the two parties are correct, the loan structure, all the amounts are also correct from the term sheet, but it has a few tells. It's missing a lot of specificity and nuance that a member of our legal team would typically include in all of the terms. It's also very summarized and not how our firm would draft an agreement like this. When I scroll down to the bottom, the signatories and addresses are captured correctly and match the term sheet. That said though, it's just 4 pages long and has around 800 words versus more than 5,000 words in our precedent document. So it kind of follows the 80-20 rule where a good portion of the response could maybe work with some edits, but it's not reflecting how my firm thinks and how it writes when authoring legal documents like this one. So let's go ahead and look at the results of a fine-tuned task-specific agent. So immediately you can see this document is verbose. It's 14 pages long with more than 5,300 words. The word count doesn't always equate to quality, so let's look at the document itself. Now as I scroll down, you'll see that this agent has been taught our firm's specific patterns and the clauses that we use in existing case files. It has structured and worded things just like the precedent document. It's reasoning and writing with more precision like an experienced member of our firm would. And while, as with any other AI-generated document, I still need to check it for accuracy, it really captures that extra detail and polish to save us time and effort. So model fine-tuning is a powerful way to tailor state-of-the-art large language models that are used behind Copilot to your specific needs. As you saw, it also can significantly improve the handling of specialized tasks. So let me explain how fine-tuning works in this case. Unlike Retrieval Augmented Generation, it doesn't rely on search and orchestration processes that run external to the large language model. The additional knowledge added as part of the fine-tuning process is a protected container of information that attaches to the large language model's training set to teach it effectively a new skill. Now, it's never merged into the LLM or used for future model training, and is temporarily attached to the LLM when it's needed. Again, the skill and knowledge that it contains is exclusive to you and the people or groups that you've shared it with, so it can't be accessed without the right permissions. So those are just a few examples of how fine-tuning in Microsoft 365 Copilot can give you on-demand expertise, and task-specific models respond more accurately using your specified voice and process so that you and your team can get more done. To find out more, check out aka.ms/fine-tuning-copilot and keep watching Microsoft Mechanics for the latest tech updates. Subscribe to our channel, and thanks for watching.